Actually, Yukari, you probably don't even need to finish the story. Just saying English is my second language, I don't know the slang, and I joined a guild in an MMO called the Backdoor Bandits. Also, Kavo, speaking of pet builds, if you ever did want to play Grim Dawn for a little bit, when the expansion comes out, there's going to be a lot of pets going on. Well, that was a weird jump. That was a weird in-camera jump. Yeah, sometimes it takes a while to find your build. Like, I think my Aether Ray guy was like the third character I had. Granted, the Arcanist was not in the game when I started playing, and if it was, it would have been my first build. Ow. I love Flesh Hulks, they're amazing. My favorite enemy in the game. Why am I even bothering fighting him? Why am I not running past him? Like, why am I wasting my time fighting three of these assholes? It's a dildo so big you can call it a mace and make it a main hand equip. Hello, Constant Convo. Arcanists are awesome. They're definitely my favorite class. Favorite mastery, I should say. Well, it probably weighs, like, a lot, right? And I would imagine it has sort of similar properties to a flail, where it's probably got some, like, you know, some sway to it. So you could get some good, you know, inertia going on the swing. Ugh. You know, this, I am actually going to skip. I just don't want to bother getting hit with that much aether damage right now. So Simpumba, I am gonna copy and paste this into a text file real quick. Because you just gave me my exclamation point Flesh Hulk bot text. So when I get to making bots, that is going to be my Flesh Hulk bot. You know, exclamation point bot things, that's going to be on there. And thank you for the follow. I missed your name, but welcome to the stream regardless. Join for 3 hours of masturbatory Grim Dawn play. Wolf overclocked. It's literally nothing. I had to refresh my chat there just to make sure my stream was working. Or I should say refresh the page just to make sure my stream is working. That always sucks, Mr. Zero. So Saboteur can actually be really fun. I've heard good things about doing, like, dual wielding with Firestrike. Dual wielding Firestrike with, Static Strike. Which one is this? Oh, Jaws. Yeah. Tri-Elemental Saboteur. It's a pretty good build. Generally, with the Sabo, you want to do, you want to do something in melee, so you can lifesteal like crazy. But you also get, you get a ridiculous amount of speed with that guy, too, because you get both Vindictive Flame and Pneumatic Burst. It's almost a little ridiculous, now that you mention it. Back in my day, computers were boxes of rocks that didn't do anything. Has anyone out there ever really thought about what a computer is? Because I saw a great description of it in like a Twitter screen cap. That was basically, computers are essentially a box of flattened out rocks that we put lightning into and tricked into thinking for itself. I'm almost 33, Yukari. You know, I think every couple of years there's someone that says that. You'll never need more than this much RAM. Or this much storage in a computer. And it's like, it's proved wrong every single time the next, like, level of that comes out. Because it's like on my mobile I can get like 64 gigs of RAM. And it's like, I'm sitting here, I'm thinking, am I ever going to need that? It's like, well, yeah, in the future I'm going to need that. Oh, someone beat you, Yukari. You know, Mr. Zoro, I'd congratulate you on making it to 60, but if I were 60, turning 60, and someone congratulated me on it, I'd probably punch him in the face. That may just be how I react to things like that, though. Hello, Clobber. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, got to get that, what, pet build going on with the ritualist? Are you going to do the vitality super mega lifesteal build? Because I could see going either way on that. For a ritualist. Yeah, Essence Drain and Wendigo Totem. It's gonna be ridiculous. Like, the Conjurer is ridiculous. That is gonna be even more ridiculous. And did I just see a follow happen and I didn't catch it? Thank you for the follow, whatever your name was that I missed. Oh, thank you, Constant.
That skill's not ready.
It's a meal so big you had to walk away from it. Oh, and Skipper hosted too. Thank you, Skipper, for the host. Yeah, my host callout's a little low on the volume. I think I had to actually go into, what's the Adobe audio program? Audition, and, punch it up a bit more. I don't know, Marlo. That's actually a really good question. Because it's like, how in the heck has vitality damage been allowed to be this for so long? Like, they did nerf lifesteal. Like, the concept of lifesteal was nerfed down. But it's like, it's like, otherwise it's like, why is it still allowed to be this way? Plans for my 40th. I want to make it to my 40th. No, but I'd say I'd, I don't know, I want to not have to work a shitty day job anymore by then. I want to have to not work a shitty day job by the end of the year. Let's put it that way. It's one step at a time. All right, you little Aether Fire Touch pricks. Come on. Oh, god damn it. Here comes the death. See, I really like having McCree saying it's your funeral. Wow, Kavo. Wow. Yep, that was a rip. It's because my character doesn't have any Aether res, and he got hit with the debuff that these heroes put on you. Who, of course, I take down in like a second. And we got this guy down here. Rip the Black Legion guy that was fighting this thing. Calvo's being pretty savage tonight. Like, really savage tonight. Oh yeah, Clobber. Entangling Vines, Devouring Swarm, Drain Essence, Wendigo Totem. Yeah, Dark Myth, that's a perfectly fine level. You'll probably immediately get to 70, and then you can immediately throw armor augments in, because you get a big chunk of experience when you first start into Ultimate. This chat is absolutely 18+. Yeah, but if you're 69, you're pretty much getting, like, almost guaranteed to get 70 right off the bat. You can craft it. The vitriolic gallstones, you can craft those. Actually, I should go get that fang real quick. It's also kind of funny you get, like, free experience for that, too, because of, like, just being able to go in the fort immediately. So I would even say, like, people in this chat under the age of 18 could probably handle what we talk about, too. I'd say it's a mature audience stream. Chat. See, I have to be careful what I say and talk about, but chat, I mean, as long as you're not being, like, racist, sexist, or homophobic, I mean, I don't see what a problem anything we've talked about so far tonight would be. Nope. Believe me, it'd probably be pretty obvious when you have to start censoring the chat. I'd also probably ask you to do it at some point if it got that bad. Exactly, Clobber. I would actually say, Kavo, just don't be really rude, like real life rude. Being fake internet bully rude is fine. I forgot Kavo's also a mod of this chat. See, the way I figure it is there are some real things in the world to be really upset about. That Twitch chat, even my own Twitch chat, why would I get upset over Twitch chat? We have a Cheeto dust colored Russian agent for a president. I think it's fine, my Twitch chat. Like, can be a little Wild Westy. Awesome, Constant. Mac and cheese is great. Oh, I'll tilt at gaming. But tilting at gaming is one thing, like... Like, being a total jerk is another. And yeah, I will absolutely tilt at the Hellblade Marathon. I tilt at that thing when I had to play it once. Wow, that was some frame droppage. Like, that was the frame droppage on my computer. That wasn't any stream lag, guys. Yeah, it's when... Tilting is when you just get really, really angry at a game. And it makes you play poorly. Grim Dawn... There are times when it does that, where it does feel really unoptimized. It's not that bad, though. To me. Pick up the scrap. Stop not picking up the scrap. Oh yeah, it's definitely way better than it used to be way back in the day. Yeah, whoops. I have that happen too, when people enter and leave my game, there's a little hiccup. Give me the scrap. Give me the scrap. Pick up the scrap. Pick up the scrap! Your inventory is its home. Don't you want to go home? Yeah, Marlo was judging my southern accent the other day. My southern accent, it's like I said, it's a TV southern accent. It's not a real southern accent. Yeah, Cavo is a chain of mistakes. Really, it's a mistake mechanism that keeps him alive and upright and functional. That is how you should react to mac and cheese. Just all of the effects I could put on these guys. Just absolutely slow everything down into a slideshow. Well, I said functional Cavo, not efficient or run smoothly or well. Oh, man. This boss is going to be really fun with exactly zero Aether resistance. Thanks for coming, Marlo. Here, brace for ass kicking.